Sons of Durin, welcome to the Beyond Sanas channel. My name is Shinx, and today we are going to take a look into the Dwarven faction in Battle for Middle-earth 1 on the patch 2.22 in the Dwarven mod. For the first time ever, solo play, skirmish, and look at that, we have now a brand new faction, the Erebor faction. Let's choose the map, Forts of Ice and against a Heart Army. Let's also pick a color, let's pick the green one, and let's get it started. Holy guacamole, another mod for Battle for Middle-earth 1. And of course, you will find the download link in the description down below. Oh my goodness, look at this beauty, guys. Built with Dwarven skill. I have no clue about this mod yet, so we will discover together. We have the chance to build the Dwarven Forge, which is going to give us money, but also same the Craftsman, which is cheaper. So let's build one of these and one of these. Just to, you know, kind of compare them with each other. I believe this is kind of like a Gondor style, because Gondor is also blacksmith and a farm is resource buildings. In PowerPoint wise, we have the chance to pick up the Horn of the Gate, which is giving us more damage and more movement speed, and also the Wow of the Vengeance. Target hero takes 25% more damage from all dwarves. I'm assuming we will be able to use it on the enemy heroes in this case, right? Not sure. But we have no cheap heroes with dwarves. We have the Rock, which is the leader of the Ravens of Erebor for 500. I believe it's like a scouting unit or hero. We have Gloin, the daddy of Gimli, for 1500. We have Gimli, the son of Gloin, for 2500. We have also Thorin III, Stonehelm, for 2600. And last but not least, Recruit Thane II, the Ironfoot, for 3100. So he's the most expensive hero. With the logic, he should also be the best hero in the game. But of course, that, you know, doesn't mean that he has to be the best 1v1 hero in the game. Just, you know, can be also like a very good sportive hero. Let's close the gate and hope for the best. So PowerPoint-wise, we can also pick up the Horn of the Gate first. And these, ladies and gentlemen, are the Arak Baruk, the Swordsman of the Dwarves. And look at the design. Doesn't look too shabby, am I right? Look at the long beards. Black, pearl gray, purple, brown, everything, you know? And we have only 4 units in the battalion. And we are cash floating, so let's build F. I'm just gonna press F and build the forge. Hopefully, that's going to be a good choice. Let's use the Rallying Call or the Horn of the Gate, and let's try to creep this. Maybe we can do that. Let's surround him and use the formation for more armor and less movement speed. Movement speed doesn't matter anything if you are standing still and fighting. So this is going to be kind of close-ish, because the Fark is actually hitting like a truck, so we need to be smart about that. And you know me, early on we will not recruit anything else but heroes exclusively. And the buff animation also looks pretty nice. Okay, they are not dealing too much damage. I believe they are like the normal swordsmen, just like the soldiers of Gondor and peasants from Rohan and orcs from Mordor and Uruks from Isengard. And I am in love with this castle. We have in total 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spots, just like Mordor and Isengard. And for the outpost, you need to invest 900, not 600. So outpost is definitely more expensive. We cannot afford that right now. But we might actually try to creep this. This, the Horn of the Gate, is reloading extremely fast. That's pretty nice. Because normally the Warchant, for example, would be still on cooldown. I don't know how long the reload time is for the Horn of the Gate, but it's definitely faster. It feels at least faster than the Warchant from Isengard. So dwarves, they are extremely slow. Oh, we have soldiers. So, and look at this. They are like pikemen, am I right? He's feeling. He's feeling the creep. Also, the redesign actually looks pretty nice. Okay, let's creep this. If we can. If we can get this, it would be actually huge. We are also getting lots of money over time, which is pretty nice. We will need a lot of money to get... Oh, he took one part of the money, which is not the best case scenario for us, but it's fine. The Warg should be able to take care of these, but again, Heart Army doesn't care, because Heart Army will have so much money that they can spam units 24/7. Our units, they are not doing a phenomenal job yet, because archers are out damaging us big time. One of the battalions is going to be taken down, unfortunately. while the Vark is still taking care of the enemy soldiers in Archers. I like that. In the melee range, however, he will be having a hard time. Oh my, can I close the gate? The gate is closed, okay. I was scared for a single second. What is the spam, my friends? The spam is crazy. So, you know what? We don't go for the Gimli because we know Gimli, even though I'm thinking that he is still, you know, having some new abilities in this mod. But I would still like to recruit a hero we don't get to see normally very often or at all in Battle for Middle-earth 1, and it is Thorin 3 Stonehelm. And later on, we might also go for we will recruit them anyway, every single one of them. We have now 3 untouched settlements outside. He's camping in front of the gate. But it's fine, he cannot enter the Erebor just yet. So, again, I'm in love with the Dwarven Fortress. It looks pretty nice to me, the castle. We have the chance to build a wall well for the sustain for the nearby units. We have to construct Royal Banner for 100% more experience and 50% more armor. We have also the chance to construct the Raven Banner for 75% more damage and 25% more range. Very interesting. And last but not least, Sulun Avanul. And for that reason, we need to first of all get the Master of the Iron Hills. I don't know what it is, but again, we will discover everything together. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is Thorin III. So that's how he looks like. I mean, he doesn't look, he has like a helmet, I guess. New design for a brand new hero. He's level 5 instantly, just like Gandalf from Gondor and Aragorn from Rohan. And we won't be able to fight for this. Level 4, let's peel back with the units. And I would like to recruit another hero before we actually make a move outside. And in the meantime, we can take a look into this hero. So basically, we have Heir of the Mountain. Grants 40% combat experience when near Dane. Okay, or gains, sorry, not grants. We have also Prince of Erebor. Leadership bonus to nearby troops. 100% attack. We have also the Mighty Blow. Knocks down and pins target hero. Normal units are knocked down and damaged. And with level 8, we get Aegis of the Erebor. Creates a Ring of Fire, which gives 30% armor and knockback fear immunity for units within the within the 60 seconds. And we have also the Stonehelm. 500% armor for 20 seconds. Causes enemies to flee in fear. I mean, they don't need to flee in fear when you have 500% armor, you don't take any damage. But we are cash floating, of course. Let's go for both of these heroes at the same time. This is going to be taken down slowly but surely. Same also to this mine, which is giving us the wealth bonus. Reduce cost of infantry by 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Depends on how many of them you have on the field. Excellent. So we will have now 3 heroes in total very, very soon, which is pretty nice. And we have also the chance to build towers. Doesn't look like that. Looks like we have no chance of building towers. But there is like a settlement. Oh, never mind. There is like a major one, and there is also like a small one. In the small one, we have the chance to build a castle tower or construct the Horn of Erebor. The echoing blast of the Horn of Erebor stuns nearby troops. Okay, anyways, we have now 3 heroes. I believe that's more than we need. We can open the gate and get out. Open the gate. Okay, this is going down. Now we need to get some experience with the heroes to unlock every single PowerPoint from their PowerPoint menu. Same also with the PowerPoints from the spellbook. So let's recapture the settlement. And I also would love to see the, you know, the design of the outpost. Oh, that is Faramir. Faramir is trying to show his quality. So let's take care of Faramir. I believe he has no chance against 3 dwarven heroes at the same time. Warning arrow will be used. Doesn't even hurt. Iron food. And that's, by the way, King Dean. So he has the King Under the Mountain, 40% defense, and 150%. Oh, Faramir has been slain in a second and a half. And we have also the Red Axe, 20% speed and 20% attack bonus to nearby units for 20 seconds. So it looks like King Dean is actually a sportive hero. Okay, I can't build that. I want to build that though. But first of all, let's recruit Gimli. Gimli, we have enough money now. Let's go. And that's Gimli's daddy, Gloin. That's how he's looking like. Well traveled. Leadership bonus to nearby troops. 10% speed. That's good. Woodscraft heals nearby units and heroes. So like Atelas, but also works for units, I guess. Let's fight this. And with level 5, we get Emissary. Hero is immune to damage, but takes penalties to damage and speed. Last 25 seconds. And also Secret Viz creates a trap at the target location. All units entering the area are immobilized. Very nice. Get inside the jeans, my friend. Gimli, you need to move. Oh, look at that. Gimli has like new abilities, Leap Attack, Extra OB, no. But Shroud, Prospector. Double the income of target mine for 50 seconds. So it's like a money-making thing. Hold on a second. We also need to do something. Do we have heal or something? I don't know. What is that? Summon. Okay, let's summon. I don't know what, but we need to summon something at this point. We need also more towers, boys. Let's build towers. I don't want to lose any of the heroes, but one of them had like sustain, right? I think this guy had sustain. No? One of them had sustain, definitely. Okay. This one, Bootcraft. So let's heal them up. Oh, that's actually a massive heal. Like we are, oh my goodness, the design though. The design of the units is looking dope. Trash Max Marksman. That looks pretty nice. Oh, these are our units, right? And these are the Gondor archers. How they are looking like, I wanna see. They look pretty much like the original ones. Not much change about them. We have 2 power points collected. And let's go for a final hero. And also let's buy all the upgrades. Okay.
Fight, dwarves.
Alright, we should be able to win this fight, no problemo. We are also getting more and more power points unlocked, as well as more and more levels. And with level 7, he unlocks the Slayer. And with level 8, Armor of Erebor, armor bonus. I don't know how much armor you will get additionally, doesn't tell. And this is like a raven, like a bird. Looks like this, I mean, nothing special really. I believe you can't even attack with him. Oh, there is Gandalf. This Gandalf is actually trying to kill us. But we have like a 5v1 situation. I mean, 4v1, because we don't count the bird. Bird can't do anything. Gandalf the Grey is Gandalf the Dead. Oh, yeah. Scream all you want, my friend. It's late. We lost the map control, but it's fine. We will be slowly but surely regaining the map control. No problemo. Let's get Banner. And also, Dwarven Heavy Armor upgrade. 1500. But for 70% more armor and 40% more knockback resistance. That's a lot of armor. Metal Lorgi upgrades for 100% more damage. And also Mithril Arrowheads upgrade for 25 increased pierce damage. Okay. Let's keep fighting. Also, let's, you know, recover the map control. There is another hero. Who's that? This is a hero, right? Yeah, I know this guy. Do you guys... What is his name from this guy? I mean, he has like... His name is Captain of Gondor, I guess. Leap attack maybe, Gimli? Can you do some shenanigans, please? There we go. Boom, son. We have also the heal in the worst case scenario. I'm not worried. I want to... I mean, that's a huge army, my friends. That's a huge army. You can also use heal. Gloin. Okay. We need some levels on Gimli, definitely. Okay. Keep fighting in the meantime. And because we will still need some time to get all the upgrades, as they are extremely expensive, boys. Okay. I believe the dwarves have no sustain. Creates a mine at the target location for 3 minutes. Drops treasure when killed. I don't know. I mean, dwarven heroes, tell me whatever you want, they are extremely thick. They are extremely beefy. I wanna... What is that? Allows a construction of Barak Shranul.
Our finest weaponsmith.
Alright, interesting. Renders all dwarves immune to fear. That's the Stout Hearts and Light of Durinstein. I believe there's like a cloud break kind of thing. So we gotta fight around this side, long story short. And we will build a wall well just to heal up. I'm assuming you can also heal up. What is the effect area? I can't tell. We are always... I believe we will be also able to heal up around this side. But we need to close the gate. Is the gate even open? Yeah, the gate is open. We need to close it. Just to make sure that we are not dying. We can also summon more units now, as we are getting outspammed all the time. And last but not least, let's go for the upgrades here. And that's gonna give us the chance to demolish one of the buildings. And finally get the chance to recruit some units.
Our halls are threatened.
And for that, we have the chance to build the Dwarven Barracks. The Dwarf Guardhouse trains elite Dwarven infantry. We have also Dwarf Hall of Elders, trains captains and increases global experience. So let's go for the elite ones first. Okay, you guys go to the well, please, and heal up slowly but surely.
Fight for your lives.
You have my attention.
What is that? Oh, that's like a leader thing, but oh my goodness, that's a huge army coming at us. The pressure is real, my friends. The pressure is real. Is the building up yet? That's how the structures are looking like. I mean, very well designed. I like this. Look at this beautiful design, guys. It's a mod from 2013, by the way. It's not like a new one. Azaghar Gundu. Three of warriors specializing in tunnel fighting must deploy to attack. Strong versus monsters, cavalry and bowmen. Weak versus swordsmen. Alright, we will, I don't know, we will take a look into that, I guess. That's a huge army. The Raven, I believe, is like an untargetable thing. He's just gonna be used for scouting, but that's a huge army, my friends. Gimli, it's your time to shine, my friend. Oh, boom, son, on your face. That's what I like to see. 7 power points collected. We need only one more for the Light of Durinsti, which is going to be like a global stun, I believe. Okay, these are the units. What is this unit looking like? What is this unit? I believe like a shielding unit. Like, the that's a very interesting skill. I like it, though. We need level 2 for the Khazad Uzbadul. So let's recruit. I mean, they are so expensive. And can you upgrade them? Yes, you can upgrade them. Pack, unpack. Oh, they are like a shield wall unit, am I right? Okay, we are fighting in the meantime, by the way, but we are taking care of all these, units. They have no chance against our Dwarven heroes. And as we are fighting, we are also getting stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger. The Dwarven faction looks definitely promising, but I would also love to take a look into the changes they have implemented into the existing factions like Gondor, Rohan, Isengard, and Mordor in the following days. So we need one more to get it to level 2. That's gonna give us the chance to recruit, I believe, one of these units. Yeah. No? I don't know. I'm still kind of a bit confused, not gonna lie. What is that? Call to arms. Calls Durin's folk to arms. Stations defense troops to guard key mines. Okay. For 1500, by the way. That's a lot. And for 1000, from a level 3 one, stations archers inside camp and castle gatehouses. So more protection. I want to see these units because they are so expensive, also in action very, very soon. So let's keep fighting here. Gimli can eventually leap attack one more time on the face of the Gondor archers. They are not even hurting. I believe they are like, they have like a crazy armor against our, against the enemy archers, the Dwarven heroes. I believe that's what's the case. Level 7. All right, I mean, we don't need that. There's like an economical boost. Let's do this. Looks interesting, right? Looks, I mean, not bad, to be honest. I would love to build that. Master of the Iron Heels. How? How am I? Wait, let me actually demolish one of them. Can you guys open the gate, please? Open the gate. Because our hero, Thorin, is taking so much damage. We have 9 power points collected. Hold on a second. Let's pick up this one. I want to see that. Decreases special power recharge time and reveals all stealth units. What is the shenanigan? Do you see the shenanigans, guys? Some black magic action is going on. They are trying to go inside the jeans, but Gimli is saying, nah, that's not even Gimli. That's Gimli. Let's deep attack one more time, Gimli. Nice, Gimli. Good job, my friend. Aragorn would be proud of you. Now we have the chance to recruit also these units. Okay, let's try. And also here, let's build, I believe there's like a statue, right? Houses and upgrades the Ravens of Erebor. I don't know, let's try that out. I have no clue what I'm doing, by the way, guys, so sorry for that. But again, you don't need to have clue, because when you get all these Dwarven heroes on the field, hold on a second, I want to try something. Hold on a second, that's a Dwarven hero, right? Yeah, I mean, Men of the West hero. So, hold on. Where is our Thorin? Okay, that's the pin. I want to see that. Let's see Cripple. Where are you, my friends? He's coming. He's coming. But I believe by the time he's arriving, this hero would be dead by now. Yeah, he's dead already. I knew it. Can you heal again? Yeah, you can heal again. This guy actually can heal up all the time. Let's fight. Let's fight this. These are the Khazad Uzbadul. So they have the chance to get into the shield transformation for more damage, less armor and less movement speed. We have the chance to bodyguard. All dwarven heroes near Khazad guard gain 10% increased armor. Of course, get them also blades, armor, as well as Panakeria to make them a bit stronger and also higher leveled. These units are body blocking quite nicely. Throw axes. So you can also throw axes actually when you want to. Let's keep fighting. We have 4 power points collected. Let's pick up this one. And what is that? Master of the... Oh, allows the... I'm blind. Sorry for that. Now I believe we get the chance to get these things, right? These things. Yeah. Now we get the chance to build them. Okay, now I know what's up. Alright, sorry. My bad. Okay. Okay, we are... What is this? Is this like a Gondonite? Are these Knights of Dol'Amroth or something? Yeah. They are actually Knights of Dol'Amroth indeed. I would love to know how much armor you get. It's like a passive thing. And these are like catapults. Yeah. Looks also pretty interesting to me. Look at this design, dude. Again, for a mod from 2013. Like 8 years ago, this was released. And I had no clue until today. I was just browsing, you know, and was looking for some potential Battle for Middle-earth mods we could be covering on our channel on YouTube. And I was like, what is that? I've never heard about this. And looks promising. Looks really promising. Okay, from this structure, I don't need Ravens, my dude. I don't need Ravens at all. So it was like a waste of time and money. We have built this one, Dwarven Barracks, Hall of Elders. Okay, let's go for Hall of Elders. Because these are the guard. This is the guardhouse, right? I mean, I believe there's like there's not like a hero. There's like a... Like a banner carrier kind of thing, right? This dude. Looks like a tower guard to me, but I'm always impressed and I need to repeat myself. The design is looking really promising.
The elders have their hall.
All right, let's build more towers and catapults just to feel a bit more safe. All right, they have no chance. They have literally no chance dealing against us, dealing with us. All right. Increased resistance to knockback by 40%. We have 5 power points collected now, which we could be using into this, which is going to make our units fear less, pretty much. Also, let's pick up this one. Can I build this behind this? I just want to see how it looks like, you know? This guy is taking damage, but... Alright, and you can just heal him up, right? Okay, that's how it looks like. It's still building, I guess. The power points are rising, and we literally don't need anything else but heroes. Increase the global experience generation rate by 3%. So let's recruit a couple of these. And a couple of these. We are broke, okay. That's how it looks like. So time remaining. Alright. You get money from it. Plus 30. That's pretty effective, actually. But it's not permanent. It's only for a set amount of duration. Alright, let's keep moving. Because what I would like to do now is the gate actually open. I cannot tell because of the design of this. Okay, now you can tell when you are actually changing the camera. Then you can tell. It's not a problem anymore. Alright. Okay, these are like one single unit. Very interesting. Okay, let's give them all the upgrades they need to make them as strong as possible. Okay, that's also a very interesting building. I'm kind of... I don't know what's going on, really. Yeah, I'm learning with you guys. Trust me on that one. All right. You know what we need to do? We need to kind of recover the map control. Because we have not a single settlement outside. Our Raven is chilling around this side, scouting. I want to see what's going on inside the Castle of Gondor. I just want to see that, you know? Hey, you want to fight? This guy. I mean, we killed him so many times. He gets one-shotted at this point. All right. They have no chance, you know, at this point, right? They have literally no chance. We are actually kind of broke all the time. Light of Durin's Day. It's already up. I mean, the game feels a bit faster, at least for this Erebor faction, because I believe everything is reloading quite fast. Power points and also the powers from the heroes. We get so much money for that. Holy moly. Okay, that's how the Gondor base is looking like. So we have double barracks, archer range. And look at this, man. This Raven is kind of unfair. Imagine like a unit which is always able to scout what you are, you know, see what you are doing. I mean, he has not even a spot in his base for the siege weapon, so We should be in a good spot. Let's fight this, no problemo.
Looks like he's getting up.
Okay, let's demolish one of the other buildings just to see the other stuff we are able to build up. I want to also see... what is that? Rams, and I think that's... I like the siege weapons. Okay, let's build this one. I want to get some siege weapons on the field.
Is ready. Get to work,
okay. I thought these are rangers or archers, but they are actually like melee fighters. They are so strong. Our units are so strong. And now we have also some defense around the mine. Do you see that? Like some defensive units spawning around the mine to protect it against the enemy attackers, which is also very interesting. Okay, this is up on the field. That's gonna give us the chance to get the siege rams and also the Sulun Abanul and limit 6. So basically, with this faction, you have like quite a lot of limitations when it comes to recruit some certain units. And also, thank you for the follow on this Twitch channel. I appreciate that. It means a lot to me, man. Thank you, thank you. All right. So let's group all together. Let's kill this farm first, yeah? We see everything. These are rangers. I want to see how they are looking like. They're also looking different. They have no mask this time. Look at them. They have no... There, in this situation, I need to say I like the design of the normal battle... The Knights of the Lamroth. I like the normal design of Battle for Middle-earth with the rangers, when they have the mask, you know, that makes them kind of look much more mysterious, you know what I'm saying? Looks much, much better. We have 7 power points collected. We need a little bit more for the ultimate one, the Durin the Deathless. Summons the avatar of Durin the Deathless to the battlefield. I have no clue what that means. Again, we will get the chance to discover together. Okay, let's keep fighting in the meantime. But what I would love to do, hold on a second, get maybe one ram. I want to see how they are looking like. I don't know about these units. Let's get these units. I don't know. Where is the barracks at? Did I not build the barracks? No, I didn't build the barracks. Because I wanted to build... Level 9. Level 10. So basically, Van Deen is low on health and is hit. He has a 25% chance to go into a terrifying rage. Temporarily gaining damage and armor as well as frightening enemy and nearby enemies. Also provides permanent 25% defense. Last defense, okay? This guy can now get 500% increased armor, Thorin. Very interesting. This guy creates a trap. Okay, let's do this. I want to see that. Immobilize, right? So, like crippled? It's kind of... Let's use Slayer. Okay, Gimli, just go into the backline. I'm telling you guys, the Dwarven heroes, they seem to be immune to arrow damage. They are extremely tanky against arrow damage. Like, no kidding, you know? Okay. So, we have a ram, and that's how a ram is... But the Dwarven armor, dude. This looks sick. Dude, I'm in love with the design already, guys. Nice. Okay, let's... You guys move bottom, please. Gimli. Like, they can keep fighting, you know, problemo, you know? Look, they are also... They are immobilized all the time. They can't move, my dude. Ignore him. Just ignore him, Gimli. You just fight here, please. And you guys just try to take down the outpost here at the bottom side. Now let's demolish this, because we have not enough space in the castle to actually... We also shouldn't, you know, demolish all the resource buildings all the time. Let's go for the regular barracks, just to see. Okay, this one is gonna give us money, that's good. Even though money-wise, it's looking pretty decent now. Fight dwarves. Fight. These are like a tank unit, I believe, right? Can you guys group, please, here? Because this guy can always use the heal. There we go, use the heal. Oh, this guy couldn't heal, though. I don't know why. Dane couldn't get the heal. All right, let's destroy. Stubborn toughness. Regenerate when not in combat. Requires level 2. Bravery. Leadership bonus to nearby infantry. So it's like a leadership-giving unit, which also is able to deal great amount of damage. I mean, we have a great defense around the castle. I'm not worried about that. As long as the Gondor is not going to be able to get any siege weapons recruited. And we have almost a chance to get the 12. There we go. Now let's take a look into that, shall we? Okay, what? Is he able... Baruch Azad. Oh, never mind. Thunder armor. Destroy the armor of enemies in the target area for 30 seconds. Okay, and last but not least, Royal Forge. Employ the Royal Forges to grant the target battalion Dwarven Metallurgy and Dwarven Heavy Armor. I don't know. It looks like a defensive unit. And also like a sportive unit, rather, sorry. And he's not even permanent. Deathless has 400% increased experience, though, for the nearby allied units. That's crazy. The Dwarven units or heroes generally, they feel extremely tough. And I like the design of this outpost of dwarves. It looks sexy, my dude. Nice. So we have three defensive things for the watchtowers and also three build spots. Let's build the hill. The statue, just to see how they are looking like, you know. And also, let's build this one. He's dying. It's fine when he's dying. I don't care about that, to be honest. Keep fighting here, no problemo. Some of them got level 10. This guy got level 10, the last defense. I mean, this guy is not even that strong, to be honest with you guys. The elders have their hold. During the deathless, he's not dead, but he's not alive either. So let's go. This is a beautiful looking outpost. Looks like a small city. Look at this tower design. I mean, look at this, boys. Do you see that? Like dwarves, you know, at the bar, you know, at weekend time, you know, Sunday. They're like, hey, let's watch Beyond Sana's channel video. All right, let's watch. Let's ho ho ho. You know, they are celebrating stuff. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. We will definitely need some more units, though. Okay, I want to build... where is the barracks? Okay. These are normal units. We've also... once it's level 2, we get the Cyan Udrik, Dwarf Spearman, and Baruch Sharahul. Rank 3. Barracks and Master of the Iron... required. Barracks, level 3, and Master of the Iron Heels. Warriors from the Iron Heels. Can wield axes and shield or in shield or heavy methods. Oh, we lost a hero. My bad. I mean, I was like very certain that our Dwarven heroes are like literally unkillable. Fight for your lives. Alright, it's the time to shine, my friend. Okay, we need to bail actually. We are actually taking now all of a sudden so much damage. Right, let's peel. Look at this protection shield around Ironfoot. That looks pretty nice too. Nice design. Okay, we need definitely some army now, boys. We need army now. Okay. Maybe we can send them automatically rally points to this farm. So this, you know, this way they can get some stuff done. And maybe we can also sneak in like a sneaky attack again. But this guy already was actually able to build multiple defensive structures. Like many trebuchet on top of the wall and so on. Okay, we have now everything unlocked from the spellbook. We were only missing this one for the fear resistance for the Dwarven units. Oh, there is the Eagle Summon. Okay, we need definitely more towers, boys. Castle Tower. Castle Tower. Castle Tower. Castle Tower. Oh, we are broke. We are broke. Okay. Gimli, can you please do some shenanigans? Did he actually kill the catapults? No, he didn't. Okay. One of the eagles is gone. Okay, we gotta go inside the jeans. We gotta go inside the jeans. It's a huge archer army there. Holy guacamole. Okay, the eagles. Our defense isn't that great, if I'm gonna be honest with you guys. Isn't that great. Because our catapults are not hitting that hard against the enemy units. They have also no chance of getting Firestone. And also extremely slow shooting. So we need to close the gate and heal up over time a little bit. Make sure that the towers are able to, or the catapults are able to handle the situation. And now let's give also our archers more damage as well as more armor. The banner upgrade is also more expensive as we were actually, you know, demolishing many of the forge resource buildings to be able to build more units. So we need definitely more. It's level 2 finally. These are the pikemen. And I believe getting them on the field is going to progress to level 3 a bit faster and sooner. Okay, so we are in trouble. Our hero is back on the field, that's good. This Gondor playstyle though. I was able to see a couple of times the Knights of Dol Amroth, but other than that, I believe he was just recruiting literally only archers. All game long. Okay, these are the dwarven pikemen. And we are broke. So we need to actually use this one more time. Behind the castle, where it's safe. And now we should be able to clean up. Let's get them banner. Okay, so we have now some units. One of them is kind of damaged, but it's fine. We can always use the emissary. No, that's one. Woodscraft. Oh, but they were not nearby. This guy is so slow. He's not able to, you know, keep up with the other ones. But it's okay. Let's get them banners. Every upgrade is purchased. Let's go. Okay, so we gotta defend this area. There are some Gondonites now. Okay, we need to, what is this shenanigan going on? Like, why are you killing our own units with the catapults? So I can't understand that. Alright, please, please, please go, 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 go. It looks like you have also the chance to build something here, but I like the tower design. I'm actually curious if you can put some units inside the jeans. This guy is looking like a logo character, you know? Doesn't look like a real one. No, you're not able to garrison the towers. That's literally not possible. And we will also need more units. I mean, we are broke. Ladies and gentlemen, we are broke. I'm fine when he destroyed the dwarf of the Hall of Elders. I don't mind about that, to be honest. Because we need to build the workshop around this side anyway. Because we need some siege weapons to be able to break through the gate and the Wall of Gondor. Okay. And during the roofless. Alright, he's attacking us slowly but surely, but he has no damage output against our catapults anyway. So I want to see if he was also capturing this outpost at the top right side. We will find out very soon. Okay, let's demolish this. Let's keep fighting. Get more units recruited at the very same time. Oh, Glein looks pretty nice though. Glein. What we built here though? I don't want to go for the ravens of Erebor. Why would I do that? Let's go for the siege works.
Show us the enemy.
Oh man, that's expensive stuff. That's really 520, dude. 520. Are you kidding me? Let's keep fighting here. Yeah, he was able to buy the outpost. That's why he has like a stable level 2 around this side. I would love to see, just to test, because I believe that this is like a very bad ultimate summon, you know? I want to see his damage against structures. Like, he deals almost no damage against structures, my friends. Like, this guy is literally not good. Okay, we need these. They cost 900, though. We are kind of broke all the time. Alright, you guys, please come off. They are dying to the rangers. Can you turn and fight them? It's fine. It's fine, it's fine, it's fine. Let's use this to make them deal a bit more damage, I guess. We are getting outnumbered, outspammed. Like, this guy literally... Look, he needs like 1 hour to destroy a blacksmith level 2, dude. That's crazy. Now we have the chance to recruit these ones. I want to see how they are looking like also. Okay, keep moving. We need definitely some siege weapons to break through the defense. We were also able to win this fight. That's good. Every upgrade purchase beside heavy armor. Give them also banner so they can respawn over time. Let's put them around this side for the defense. I mean, he's tanky, don't get me wrong. And he's also like having a long time remaining. He's not like anywhere close to the time remaining of Army of the Dead or the Balrog summon. But also by far not as powerful. The Eagle summon will be used once again. And the Eagles here, they are not even able to take down our catapults fast enough. But also towers are not dealing too much damage to the Eagles either, so... Okay, let's give them heavy armor, I guess. Let's collect them all together. That's how the catapult is looking like, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, we were actually kind of overcommitting. The Eagles are coming. Oh, yeah, the Durin is gone, but it's fine. Alright, let's keep fighting now. And we will definitely need more than only one siege weapon, that's for sure. Okay. I don't know what I can do now. Like, I have no clue what this is what this means. Target hero takes 35% more damage from all the dwarves. So am I supposed to use it on an enemy hero? And the enemy hero takes more damage from our dwarven units? Is this how it's Hope it's working. Can't tell.
You see, we are busy.
Hold on a second.
Enemies at the gate.
Glider ammunition.
I want to see this damage output. Are we going to be able to outrange this? No, the answer is no.
Fight for your lives.
Okay, that deals literally no damage.
Let fly.
Gimli, could you please throw a rock axe? Okay, that's not one-shotting it, which kind of makes sense.
Can't you see we are busy?
Alright, so we gotta peel back, because the Katas are gonna demolish us if we don't back off. Oh, we forgot to close the gate, didn't we? Yeah, we forgot to close the gate, boys. So let's close the gate. I actually pretty surprised that this faction doesn't even have a postern gate. Oh, that is a... I'm blind. That's what it is. Okay, I'm blind. You guys come here, please. Okay, we broke one part of the wall, not the wall, but we killed one of the trebuchet. That's good. We have also 400 command points available. Oh, we need to replace it. It's fine now. Okay, you guys, please, can you move here? You should be able to move here, right? Yeah. Okay. Oh, we are taking so much damage. Every hero is now level 10. This guy, once again, has a stone helm for 500% increased armor. So I have a plan. Once we are able to get into the castle, we can use the stone helm to make him tank all the damage. With 500% increased armor, he should be able to absorb so much damage for free. And let's crowd control them also. And Gimli, you do you, my friends. Look how many captains he has. Okay. Alright, we are being attacked now from this area. But we can, we should be able to fight this. Let's recruit a couple of these. More archers, I guess. For the defense. You keep fighting here, my friend. You keep fighting here, you keep fighting here, you keep fighting here. And you can keep also fighting, boys. Alright, can we win this fight? We should be able to win this fight, right? Yeah, we are able to win this fight. That's good. So where are our catapults at? We have three of them now. That's good. So let's move. This guy level 10 is hitting like a truck. Gimli also hitting like a truck. I mean, obviously now everyone is level 10. But also when they were underleveled, they were still extremely tanky. Maybe they are like having some weaknesses against Wardmen, because archers are definitely not their weakness. Trust me on that one. Heavy armor, upgrades. This alternate weapon.
Throw your
swords. Oh, deflect swords and the chance to fight also with axes. Okay.
Think I can hit it?
Gondor Knights are coming now, but it's fine. We should be able to win this fight. Why don't you shoot? There is one guy able to survive, you know? Just shoot him down.
They're attacking our kinsfolk.
You need to protect this catapult, please. Okay, one part of the wall broken. Dope. Don't lose the catapult! Oh, this catapult is so slow. Can't move, you know? Okay, we killed it, but it's a little bit too late. The walls are way squishier, or these catapults are just hitting extremely hard. Like, what is this? Like, normally, they can take a little bit more damage than that. Like, this is crazy how squishy the walls are. Okay, we need definitely a bit more stuff. Alright, so let's go like this. Let's go like this. Bring all the stuff together here. We have still two. Okay. Gimli, just do your thing. You do you, my friend. Here. Here, please. Okay. And you, my friend. I don't know what you can do. Alright. And you can keep crushing the... I want to see the damage against structures like Blacksmith, for example, now. I want to see that. I see Peregrine took. You full of a took. And also Faramir, the captain of Gondor. Kill them. Okay, the damage output against the structures isn't the greatest. It's also able to miss. Oh, hold on a second. We need to defend this. Catapults, that's very important.
Our kinsfolk.
I will go. Looks like he's getting up. Load another.
This guy's trying hard to kill our catapult.
Can't you see we are busy?
Alright, so our damage output against structures. The wall is high, But again, structure is not that high. Let's see them all banners. Is that a well? There is a well, right? So we can actually send them here to sustain over time. Eagle summon for the third time or so. They're teleporting now. What's going on?
And you see we are busy.
Okay, just keep crush the wall, I guess. Stand firm. The enemy is hold on, hold on, hold on. Please don't die. Please don't die. Actually, we can use the 500 armor on your face, huh?
Looks like he's getting up.
Break every part of the wall. Yeah, yeah. Do that, my friend. Do that. Okay, we can't break it, but we have now enough options to enter the Gondor castle. Trust me on that one. Like, there is no chance of Gondor defending our next incoming big attack. Just make sure that this guy is not able is able to get away. That would be huge if we can save him. And he's still red, by the way. I mean, now it's like, I don't know how long this is lasting for. For 20 seconds. Okay, that's a long time in RTS games. Trust me. Okay, let's peel back. Wait for the army. We need definitely more archers, but as you can see and tell, we are always broke. We have no money all game long because we have to invest so much money. Gimli, can you just jump here? Gimli, where are you? Oh, never mind. Gimli's already in safety. They are trying to kill Gloin, but Gloin is also tanky. Okay, we missed it, kinda. Gimli can just solo that, right? Gimli just can solo that. What task requires the arms? Okay. Okay, everyone is upgraded now. That's good. And we also need, I believe, swordsmen. That's what we need in order to be able to deal the damage to this structure. So Gimli soloing. Fight dwarves. Fight for kinda. He's also taking a lot of damage though. So now let's reinforce Gimli. There is also some action going on. My dwarves are ready for war. I mean, we need to find a way of getting a bit more money. That's kind of scary that we are always broke like that. Gimli, can you please X-throw, my friends? Right in the middle. X-throw is also dealing splash damage. Okay. That means it's able to hit multiple units at the same time. Stand firm. Nearby units, 100% damage. Okay, we don't need to use that. We have now strong backline and also strong frontline. I hope. Let's use also this one for more range, more damage, but we also lose movement speed out of that. But it's okay though. We should be able to protect ourselves at least for now. We need definitely some sort of damage output against structures. And as you could see, our catapults, our siege weapons are not dealing that much damage to the structures. So we need definitely something else in that. Okay, can you please heal? There we go, nice. Gimli, just use Slayer once again. Run them down. I mean, he was getting Gandalf only one single time on the field. As Grey, we killed him. And he never ever recruited Gandalf again. Okay, you guys. Just please, I mean, maybe I'm gonna use them for the map control fights. Looks like this faction has no cavalry. I think so. I mean, I couldn't see any cav units. So now is the time for us to shine. This is still on cooldown. Let's use this for the stun. And also, let's summon the reinforcements. Let's use also war chant. I call it war chant, but you know what it's supposed to mean, you know. Let's use the leap attack on the tower guards. They are also looking pretty nice with these big shields. I like that so much for how they are looking like. Now is the question about the damage output against structures. That's the big question we have. Okay.
Our halls are threatened.
Wait a second, we need to extra. Oh, where are the catapults from him? Oh, did he demolish them? He had catapults, right? We didn't kill them, actually. They're attacking our kinsfolk. Is that a catapult? No. Okay, so you know what? I take it. No catapults, no problemo. Like, he's annoying now at this point. Can you please fight this? Okay. We will lose this meal. Bring me to them. The enemy is tenacious. All right. This and this. Okay.
Their mind is kinsfolk. Get to work, lads.
Raise the colors of Erebor.
Can we finish this off? That's the big question. I think we should be able to. I don't know. We are taking so much damage now, but where is our This guy. Okay, we killed the Citadel, that's good. Let's use this. And also let's use our Durin the Deathless. I mean, I am kind of, you know, it's a little bit too much information for myself to in the first game ever. That is some, I mean, it's a brand new faction, which is not only a small faction with bunch of heroes, abilities, you know, new units, upgrades, everything is literally changed. And as far as I can see, also Gondor got changed. Like, what are these units? Are they called Tower Guards? Citadel Guards. They are looking amazing. Like, the design of this is looking really next level. I'm in love with that. Keep fighting, no problemo. We should be able to take down the castle now. Right? Yeah, I think we should be able to do that. Our heroes are kind of still healthy. That means we should be in a good spot. So this castle, ladies and gentlemen, has been destroyed. That means we have only one single outpost to be done with for being victorious. However, we need to still deal with this enemy units around this side. And also around this side. Our units are doing this eagle summons all the time. Annoying. Okay. I believe this is going to make them shoot also when they are level 3. Let's summon this one more time to get a bit more money. Okay, you guys, we need to capture this one. I believe we also need to invest 5,000. Depends, of course, they can change the prices of all the time. The outpost normally costs 600, but in this case, it costs you 900. And the castle costs you also more. Not 5, but 6,000. So, lots of money has to be invested into that. We are actually surprisingly doing a good job in the middle of the game map. Okay. No. We need to actually save money, of course. I mean, never mind. We don't need to buy this castle, right? What is this? Aragorn? Did he actually summon him or something? Well, Aragorn is in Gondor here. It looks also different. I want to see that. Aragorn. What can Aragorn do against such a reckless seed?
They're attacking our kinsfolk.
He has no chance. He has literally no chance. Oh, the raven got kind of focused from somebody. I don't know what was attacking the raven, but he's almost gone. Hopefully, this guy won't be able to recapture this castle. That would be kind of the worst case scenario, you know what I'm saying? Okay. What is the waypoint? It's here. Okay. So, we can at least recruit more units in the meantime because we are not buying the castle anyway. Let's use Rallying Horn or the Horn of the Gate. There is Gandalf Grey. Gandalf, my friend, you have no power here. The mighty blow is on cooldown. Okay, Gandalf is paper against our units at this point. He has no chance. Where is your daddy? There we go. Let's use the heal. This is, by the way, busted also. Like, you see how fast it's reloading? Do you see that? I believe this is like a 20 seconds cooldown or something. Imagine, like, a situation. And again, we are playing against a hard army, which is able to spam units all the time. Imagine if this is not the case. Imagine if you have, like, heroes only in your opponent can't even kill them because you will have so much sustain. However, we also need to understand that there is no heal ability for the Dwarven faction in Battle for Middle of One here, you know? So it's a matter of time. Slayer is on cooldown, but we don't need Slayer. Just jump here in between the structures. Doesn't deal any damage though. It deals some damage, like minimum damage. Let's summon the Man of Steel. Also, these units are looking sexy. Look at them. Do you see that? And they have like a leader always. Captain Artano. And look at this design of the Man of Steel. I like it, man. That really looks dope. And Erebor will be victorious as the Hard Army has been defeated. Overall, this one... I mean, by the way, we are also on the patch 2.22. And let me tell you that much, guys, the hard armies in BFME 1 on the patch 2.22 feel overall much, much harder. You see the money difference at the end of the game, even though we were able to win, we were still down nearly 20,000 resources. But it was a great experience. I like the Erebor faction a lot. And this mod is looking pretty promising to me. And again, the only faction they added is Erebor, but of course, that's not the only thing they change. So before we're gonna end the video, I wanna just take a look into the Mordor, and maybe you wanna do the same. So let's jump right into the model faction. I want to just see the heroes and also the structures you are able to build. Nothing else. Okay? So, yeah, look at that. We have Gorbak. We have Gollum for 50. We have also Shagrat. We have the Nazgul for 1800. And we have the Witch King for 2600. So everything. And you have 800 command points, by the way. Okay. The structures are looking the same. PowerPoint-wise, we have the Tainted Land. Okay, that looks the same. Slave Field of Nurn. Orc Pits, Troll Kitchens, Siege Wars, Mumak Kill Pants, and Haradrim Palaces slowly... okay, what? Slowly produce resources. Dude, you can get from your production buildings. Imagine this on a hard army. That would make the hard army crazy. Scavenger. Sorcery of Dol Guldur. Invokes the Sorcery of Dol Guldur to summon a Castellan and cause enemies to flee from the casting location. Darkness called the Horde. And then we have the Dark Tower. Allows one of your citadels to be converted into a Dark Tower. That's scary. And also look at the Orc Pit. Dude. Spirit training upgrade. Increase health. Purchase the upgrade at the structure. Then select any unit and upgrade the unit. So we have orcs for free. Orc archers. We have the orcs of Morgul. There is like so much stuff. And that's only the orc pit. You have not even taken a look into the Haradrim Palace. So guys, let me know please in the comment section down below. Which faction would you like to get covered in the next one? Erebor is the brand new faction. But trust me, as you can see yourself, every faction got a facelift. Got a rework. And you will decide which one will be the next. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck, and as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.